Come on, somebody. No weapon formed against me. Do I have any worshipers out there today that will tell the enemy, no weapon formed? You better claim it today. No weapon, no weapon, no weapon formed against me. Yes. Any worshipers? Come on, tell them, say, God will do what he said he would do. Oh yeah, worship him. Hallelujah. Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Hallelujah. Formed against me will prosper. Don't be afraid this morning. There just ain't one. Hallelujah, Jesus. They no. Tell them, say, no, it won't work. It just won't work because I'm not going to let it. Woo, hallelujah. Alexa, turn off. Amen. Wake up in your mind. Get up in your thinking and move in your purpose. God bless you guys. I'm glad to be back with you in the studio. Alexa, turn off. Oh, look, she was about to go. Blessed in the city, blessed in the field, blessed when I'm coming, when I'm going. You know why? Because no weapon formed against me will prosper. Prep mode, come on, we are in vessel preparation mode in this season, and we're getting ready to cross over, you guys. We get ready to get this thing together. We're already learning how we've already been given the equipment to operate in the works of God and doing the things of him. We even talked about on Monday that if you needed to know what are the characteristics of the Spirit, we went to Galatians 5. We're going to go right there for 1 second. But remember, we now can take on these attributes to say, I know how to operate. Operation is the most important thing, especially in vessel preparation, because if you are not operating correctly, your vessel may crash. Mm. If you're not operating correctly, your vessel may fail. And here, let me put this to you even greater. If you're not operating in excellence, your vessel may not get you where you're supposed to be going. We call it the stuck syndrome. Where you just feel like you're stuck, you can't go nowhere, nothing's working. It's because we've been operating with the inability to operate with the ability of the gifts of the Spirit. Someone says, "Well, I'm gonna walk on water." You better wait a minute. Some people say, "I'm gonna raise the dead." You better stop. Some people say, "You're gonna do this, you're gonna do that." No. We've learned a long time ago when you are a believer. A believer in what? In Jesus Christ, in his works, and knowing that it's only through him that we can get to the Father, you now can do also. Oh, and then as we operate the Spirit, he even went farther and said, greater works will you do. We're still looking for the same miracles. We're still looking for the same situations to manifest instead of looking for new works, new operations, new ways of walking in the Spirit and not fulfilling the flesh, and knowing that we're being successful. We're being successful in what God has called us to do. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. That's what new is, that I know how to operate and walk in the new. That I know how to yes, thank you, Minister Charlene, to operate in faith over fear. See, when you operate in the spirit, there is no physical, nothing that can harm you physically. No weapon formed against me will prosper. That didn't say it won't come against me. It said it won't prosper. I'm not going to give it to your devices anymore. I'm not going to allow you to affect me in such a way that I'm losing the battle, the good fight of faith. Faith over fear. You got to go to another level in your faith that you're not failing. You see the results. I don't care if I preach that every time we preach. You must see results. You're not waiting for Christ to come to see results. You're waiting on Christ to come so you can see new. My God. I want to see Christ in the new. I want to experience the new Jerusalem. The new. Oh my God. Do you see the word of God? And it says that things will be new. Something never, ever, ever, ever experienced before. But no, we want to see a repeat. We want to see the same thing over and over again. Instead of saying, no weapon formed against me will prosper. Why? Because of love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. But watch this. Minister Terry made me go back to the archives, because if you go back up into 16, oh, Jesus. You got to be a faith walker, because you got to walk by the Spirit. What is faith walking? Walking by faith, not by sight. My God, faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Are you seeing the unseen? Sow them seeds. You see Minister Terry already posted on there. No, we shouldn't even be pushed to do it. Sow your offering and your good tithe seeding. If you're a member here, sow your tithes. Get your harvest. Go on. Oh, Minister Shannon just ran. Minister Terry just ran. Minister Charlene just ran. Say, I know for a fact I've sown in the good ground and I am a result. I'm a result of my favor, because I operate in the spirit. But watch this. Verse 16, it says, I say then. Hold on. Let me move some of these case covers and stuff. I rushed in here today, y'all. I say then, walk in the spirit and you shall. Now, watch this. Remember, the word shall is a promise. If you sow, you will be blessed. Are you expecting it? I tell you, every time I sow to receive. No, and this hardly ever finances. It's always grace, favor, to be able to receive an understanding of the Spirit and operate in love, joy, long peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, gentleness, self-control. Against there is no law. But I say then, walk in the Spirit, and you shall not, watch this, and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Don't you know that's not getting filled? That's walking. Oh, somebody took off running. Somebody said, no, I graduated. I'm running in the spirit now. See, for everything, every gift, and every good thing God has given you and I, we must always excel. We must always go higher. Yeah, I was a baby, but no longer. I'm an adult now, and I'm not eating baby food no more. I am eating the substance of God's word that I can now see different. I'm different. You're different. Oh, Jesus. My mentor was listening to some of the broadcasts the other day. He said, son, you should be all over the place. I said, I am. Don't look at the numbers. No, I'm operating in the spirit. I can tell you right now, late in the midnight hour, you be going through some things and my spirit be all up in your neck saying, you better stop. You better get up. You better run. You better call Jesus. You better stay and run, walk, live in the spirit. I say then, walk in the spirit and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Now watch this, watch this, watch this, watch this. That's where walking comes important. It is the ammunition that you have to fight the flesh by walking in the spirit. No, when you run in the spirit, you're in a whole nother thing. You in victory. No. See, when you walk in the spirit, he said it. He says, walk in the spirit and you. Who's he talking to? Me. I'm sharing. I told you this is my real life. My reality show of how the word of God is working me every day, telling me how to walk. My God. You got to walk before you can run. Thank you, Minister Cynthia. See, you a walker too, but now you can run. Don't get complacent and say, well, I am walking in the spirit. No, now it's time to run. Don't you know it's some more things of this age that is coming against us? We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, rulers of darkness in heavenly places of this age. My God, stand in this age, Jesus. And walk in the spirit, and you shall not. He's promising you. If you and I walk in the spirit, we will not fulfill the lust of the flesh. No, see, when you run in the spirit, now you're showing somebody else how to run. When you're walking, you're handling your own things. Oh, no, we just came out of self-examination. But watch this. When you're walking is when you say no to the flesh. Oh, I'm not fulfilling that. No, I'm walking in the spirit. Oh, I know it's challenging. I know people are all up in your ear. I know your body be talking to you too. No, I am walking in the spirit because I know I will not fulfill the lust of my flesh. That's your problem. That used to be my problem. I'm worried about the walk in your flesh. No, don't fulfill the lust of my flesh. My lusts are different than yours. They may meet up somewhere in joy, in feelings and emotions, but no, my lusts are different than yours. That's why I cannot stop you from fulfilling the lust of your flesh. I don't know your flesh like you do. And I'm going to tell you right now, you might think you do, but you don't know my flesh like I do. Minister Terry, you better run. You better tell him. Pastor, he'll tell you all day long. Your biggest enemy is you. I am my biggest enemy. No, I'm not blaming nobody no more. I'm not throwing nobody else under the bus. I am the bus, and I am all of that. I am the reason for my faults and my failures. No, nobody else. But I have learned to walk in the spirit. We can go back in the day, just talking about me. Even in ministry, some people would say, no, y'all just don't know. He has grown. Because I was walking in the flesh, even in church, even in building ministries, even in mentoring. No. I was a terrible mess. Terrible. Jesus. But God gave me the opportunity to shift it. Come on to the playground, y'all. I know some of y'all been waiting on me to tell you that. Come on. You don't need an invitation. The playground is a neutral space that we all should just be fellowshipping in. What? In the spirit. You don't need a plane ticket. You don't need a bus ride. You don't need a car. And you don't need no gas. All you need is to walk in the spirit. See, we're talking about Operation Spirit Move. If you're not walking, how are you going to operate in it? Because that means you're fulfilling the lust of your flesh. Watch this. For the flesh lusts against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. Stop right there. They are equally unyoked. It's not like the spirit is just trying to kill the flesh. It ain't like the flesh just trying to kill the spirit. No, they both are in war against each other. That's why you got to move in the spirit. Because the other spirit, it's one, you're going to move one way or the other. Well, you be like, no, I'm just in the middle. I'm just holding on, waiting on God's unchanging hand. No, you're not. You're going to go one way or the other. You're going to run with the spirit of this world, or you're going to run with the spirit of God. But you must first learn how to walk so you can manage your flesh. I know you need to write that down. You'd say, ooh, you're looking for a pen. Ooh, what the hell, where did that come from? Yeah, you better learn to walk in the spirit or you will never handle your flesh. That's why the flesh keep winning on you. That's why you keep coming back crying. That's why you, look, I'm going to say this loud and clear. I'm going to say this loud and clear. And I hope you are one of my people that are close to me. There is no excuse. Watch this. I'm telling you from experience because I did it. There is no excuse for a relapse. No, we go through hell. Yes, we are going to experience depression. Yes, but if you walk in the spirit, you will not fulfill the lust of the flesh. The only reason that you went back to that is because the flesh started talking to you more than you was letting the spirit talk. The truth hurt, but the truth is going to set you free today. And if you know somebody that needs to hear that right there, I need you to share this. Stop making excuses. No. If you walk in the spirit, you will not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Your only problem is family, brother or sister, sister or brother, minister, pastor, fivefold, whatever, is that you have not learned how to manage your flesh. You ain't never, yeah, yes, I have. You ain't never went through that. Yes, I did. You ain't never used that before. Yes, I have. No. There is nothing but one thing that you could come at me with and I'd be like, well, no, I've experienced that in an arena, but I've never done it. But there ain't nothing else that you could put on me and say, you don't know that. You ain't been through that. The devil is a lie. I am experienced. No, I don't stand out. Let me tell you my testimony. My testimony ain't for everybody. No, excuse me. Thank you, Holy Ghost. My testimony is for everybody. You know what my testimony is? Jesus Christ is Lord. I am living proof that Jesus Christ is Lord. I am proof that Jesus Christ lives in me this day. But my story ain't for everybody. See, that's why people be flipping. Can you tell your story? And it sounds so good. Watch this. It sounds so good that people think they can do it. You just tempt that person too much because you went through it and had the strength and the fortitude to do it. Their lust is not your lust. They don't have the same fortitude to hear what you got through. They just need to see that you did. And how did you do it? By learning how to manage my flesh. You cannot operate the spirit, family, if you have not managed your flesh. No, you, that doesn't make you perfect. No, it don't. It makes you right. Look, check this out. Righteousness is when you make right choices. That makes you righteous. It didn't say that you didn't have to resist. You're gonna have to resist. Look, it says, for the flesh lusts against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. The word lust is a desire to manage, to take over, and to be in total control. No. Lust ain't sex. Lust ain't that. No. Lust is control. Woo! He let it go today through this. He let y'all hear it loud and clear. Watch this. Lust is the problem. Because you got one, I got one, and we all try to fulfill the flesh through our lust. And guess what? It won't work. Because... watch this. It says, and these are contrary. Do you know what contrary means? they are on different pages. They don't agree on nothing. Contrary means you can't make sense of a conversation they having. Their plans don't have, you know, some people plans were like, well, we found some common ground. When you come into the flesh and the spirit, there's no common ground. Stop thinking there is. Well, I can do this and I'm going to get away with it. I give God more. Well, yeah, it starts out that way. But the more you give God, the less you give yourself. Don't you know this ain't about the world. This is about you. This is about me getting my flesh in order because I got to stop fulfilling it. Thank you, Minister Charlene, Evangelist Charlene, Prophetess Charlene. Lust is control. People hear the word lust and they think, oh, that's between my legs. That ain't, no, uh-uh. Control is between your legs. That comes from lust. Lust wants to control. Period. And the lust of what? The flesh. So what? Who wants to control? The spirit. Now, watch this. It's incomparable to even put the spirit in this conversation when it comes to me and you, because it's the flesh that we have a problem with. But you must know that there is no agreement there. Oh, maybe I just heard it wrong. No, you didn't. No, you didn't. It was totally wrong. Or maybe I just didn't get. No, you didn't. No, it was wrong. No. There is no in between in that you got something off. You thought it came from the spirit and it looked like the flesh. That was nothing but the flesh disguising itself as the spirit. But see, you got to learn to walk in it. Come on, walk in it. Walk it out. Walk it out. Come on, walk in it. Walk in it. Say, walk it out. Say, I'm walking in it. See, when you learn to walk in it, you know how to stay in it. When you learn to walk in it, watch this. It says, so that you do not do the things that you wish. Don't you see how this is a zoned in principle of how you have to manage you? You cannot operate. You cannot work. You cannot have the gifts of the spirit if you still don't have control over your flesh. It's imperative. You must get control of your flesh. Family, I'm just being as honest as I can with you. You must get in control of your flesh. The only way you can win. It's the only way you can win. Watch this. Now, the works of the flesh are evident. Now, we understand. It's a little, you know, that I went with the fruits over the works. Reason being is that the fruit will grow in you and multiply in you. The works will only be the actions you take. Watch that. That's going to catch up with you. The spirit, the fruit of the spirit will feed you, the vine. Remember the vine principle? If you're in him, he's in you, you will multiply, you will produce much. You will ask whatever you ask and it will be given because of your connection with the vine, that 720 degree, that 720 degree turn. You're turning away from yourself 360 and turning to him 360 at the same time, simultaneously, and you're seeing the results of the spread, the room, the ability that you do not have to lose no more. Losing is the biggest thing for us because it happens in the flesh. And then we blame the spirit. It wasn't the spirit's fault. That was your fault because you didn't get it in control. And you thought you had it all together and you just needed a little bit more time in getting it all the way locked in. There you go, Minister Charlene. Repent fast. Pray. Resist and stand against its lust. Now, here's the good news. If something I've said this morning is triggering something into you, be like, you know what? You are right. Thank you. See, Minister Rhonda said, you know what? I'm going to read the book again. Yes. The Now Experience, in its own gift, has a lot of nuggets if you just really go in and see the fruits of what God has. If you say, I've never received the Now Experience, go on Amazon, search Dr. Edward Hamilton, the Now Experience. The book is $15 on Kindle and $20 to buy a copy. If you want a copy from me signed, go to Cash App. Send me $25, $20 for the book, $5 for shipping. I'm going to sign it to you and put it in the mail. It's a must read, especially going to the next level, because we are going to bring out the 720 degree turn that will complement the now experience. You need it. I need it. And yes, all of your finances that you sow into this ministry goes to continue this work without beg, borrowing, or stealing, that we can be fruit in this community, in this city, in this county, in this state, in this nation, and then the world. We really believe, family, home is the most important thing that you and I should be working on. You see, the pandemic that shut down a lot of stuff that you thought, well, why are we being punished and things like that? If it ain't working, look, if it ain't working, then why keep it going? If all the churches, the doors were open, I'm going to tell you how much of a believer I am in Jesus Christ and his covering and his ability to let no weapon formed against me prosper, is that if everything was going right, and I'm not saying everybody's wrong. I'm not even saying who's wrong. If the shoe fits, wear it. But if we shut down and we can't find other ways to be effective, then that means we wasn't being effective in the first place. I'm not saying that just because that's what I do, because nothing changed in what I do. I do everything I did before the pandemic, even more during the pandemic, and even more after the pandemic. That's just what we do. That's not blaming or saying nobody else is less or greater than us. That's just saying that's what we do. But if what you're doing is not being effective, that's the reason your doors are shut. If what you're doing is not being effective now in the pandemic, how do you think they're going to come back after the pandemic? If you haven't been there in support during hell, why when hell is gone, you think they're going to come back and support you? I had to run on that one. And watch this. Everything that's done or happens, you and I as believers should look for what? What should we be looking for? One person, just one person. We get, okay, all of a sudden, here's an obstacle. You've heard me say it before, so this ain't a trick question. Here's an obstacle. It's bad, too. What should you do? Cower? Quit? Wait? Give up? No. First thing, don't panic. Second thing, pray. Third thing, look for an opportunity out of every obstacle. I don't care how bad it get. I'm going to find a way to give God glory. I don't care how crazy it looks. I'm going to find a way to give God glory. All you got to do is look. I told you before. All you got to do is look up just a little bit. Every time that obstacle comes, just stop where you are. Don't panic. Pray. And just look up. Say, Lord. I will take off running. Somebody took off running. Come on, take off running. My God. Every obstacle, there's an opportunity to give God glory. I didn't say give me glory. I didn't say give you glory. No, I said give him glory and keep it moving. When? Now. And don't fall into the devices of works. That's why I didn't say works of the Spirit. I said operation in the Spirit. Remember, you got to be baptized. You got to be filled. And you must operate to see the full effects of what God is doing. I'm telling you, this is going to be a chapter in the 720 degree turn. spirit versus flesh. It's gonna be a chapter in that book. It's a principle we're designing right now, drawings and everything, that's gonna be implemented in this ministry and to those that are under and with connected with this ministry, that we learn how to operate in the spirit. Now, here's a test for us right now. You may be in the same state as I am. You could be right next door, but we are not in the same geographical, physical place. You may be in Texas. You may be in Louisiana. You may be in San Diego. You may be in Detroit. You may be in Long Beach. You may be in New York. You may be, and I'm not even going to scroll through everything, but you may, wherever you are, I want you and I to just settle down and agree that he's in this presence. Come on, join spiritual hands with me right now, where you are, where you are. I know you felt that because I did. Oh, somebody else just joined. Somebody else just joined. Come on, everybody, come on in. Come on in. No matter where you are, I want to show you how God is going to prove to us right now that he is working in the spirit and not in the flesh. Oh, thank you. Somebody grabbed on and still running. But agree and be on one accord and unify right now in the name that is above every name, the name that every knee will bow, the name that every tongue will confess. Jesus is in the midst of this fellowship. Ooh, thank you. Ooh, somebody else agreed. Somebody else agreed. Ooh, you felt that? Oh, somebody else agreed. Oh, hey, my shot. Oh, Jesus. Somebody got healed through their agreement. Somebody got delivered through their agreement. Somebody got touched in the spirit by agreement, because it's not by power, it's not by might, but it's by the spirit of God that we believe, that we walk by faith and not by sight. Do you feel it? See, God move in us right now, because he said, when there are two or three gathered together in his name, he's in the midst. Let me give you my experience. It's like the tips of my fingers are tingling, because I feel the tips of your fingertips tingling. There is a pulsing through each tip of my finger right now, I'm telling you. And I know you feel it. I know you feel it. I know you feel it. It's like a little, like this. Wherever you are, Texas just said yes. Ooh, wow, my shanda. Jesus. Clap, come on. Oh, do this with me. God said, clap your hands. And receive the spirit right now in the name of Jesus. Jesus, thank you. Go ahead, run. Now, some people, you ain't got to move. Your spirit is ran. You can't stop running. And I'm going to show you that healing, Latasha. Hey, kanda, I'm going to shut up. I dare you to touch somebody. Oh, I dare you to just lay your hands on somebody. They don't even have to know what you're doing. Don't tell them ahead of time. Just touch them. Hey, say, I touched the hem of his garment this morning. Jesus. See, that's the working of the fivefold. Oh, that is the working of the Spirit right now. That is the working of the Spirit. And you're experiencing this with me, that you could be a witness. That this ain't no hocus pocus. This ain't no holly ba da da. This is the Spirit of God. When we fulfill the lust, because I know some of y'all flesh said quit. Some of y'all flesh said this ain't working. Some of y'all flesh, well, I'm at work, I can't get up. If you walk in the spirit, all those negativities that the flesh will try to hinder you with will be loosed in the name of Jesus. Oh, you felt that? I love you, Lord. And I lift my voice to worship you, oh my soul, rejoice. Take joy, my King, in what you hear. Let it be a sweet, sweet sound. Let it be a sweet, sweet sound. Oh, Jesus. Let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your ear. Glory. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you for your wonder-working power. Thank you for forgiving us. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for moving in this moment, in this season, and showing yourself to everyone willing to receive that you are God. You are true. Thank you. Thank you. I don't know if you ever experienced that when God has given you a prophetic word to speak into people's lives. And all of a sudden, as he's giving it to me to speak to you, he just said something and said, no, this is for you, son. Stop. Don't share this. Don't give this. He said, this is for you. He said, but you can't open up the doors of the church and give people an opportunity to sow into this ministry, because those that I'm seeking are the ones that are hanging out right here. Somebody said, what do you mean by that? The Bible says that he is seeking such to worship him, true worshipers. It's not about man, it's not about woman, it's about spirit, and it's about relationship. Minister Terry has texted the ways that you can sow. Someone sowed at the beginning of the, somebody was on our Cash App at the beginning of this broadcast. You are going to be flabbergasted over what is about to happen for you. And you gave so willfully. You had such joy in giving. You're going to have more joy receiving. Yes, because you want to give more. You want to do more in your city, in your community. You thought you were supposed to leave your place of residence. Nuh-uh, God got to work for you right there. The connections that you have gotten all across this country or all across this world are meant for you and your work right where you are in your own home. I know they didn't receive you. I know they didn't listen to you. I'll tell you, I was the first one in Compton, L.A., Linwood, where I used to slang dope, smoke dope, use dope, do everything else. Oh, I come around preaching. They look at me like, oh, that ain't number Goldie. That ain't number this. That ain't number that. But when God released in me a word for my land, I haven't been turned away since. As a matter of fact, I couldn't leave California again. Y'all know me. I done lived in probably 35, 36 states in this country in my lifetime. Yes, I have. And couldn't settle nowhere. And he brought me home to work in my own city, in my own hood, in my own blocks. That I would never believe I'd be back in that area of the memories that I have endured. But God. And fulfilling his promise of not operating and fulfilling the lust of my flesh. Yes, you can do it. You can do it. And guess what? We're going to do it together. Now, you may be out there and say, well, man, everything you said was on me. I'm no good. That's a lie from the pit. Don't listen to that lie. No, you check this out. Check this out. No. That was for you to wake you up. That's all. I'm not here to beat nobody down. Let me tell you something. You are God's greatest miracle. He favors you so much. He did great things for you that you can now see today how to shift things, how to convert things, and how to become a child of God. You can do it. if you got anything out this message today, it's to tell you, don't give up. Don't throw in the towel. Do not, you can do it. All you got to do is wake up in your mind and say enough is enough. Get up in your spirit. Get up in your thinking and let the mind of Christ be in you and now move in your purpose that you can now become a disciple, that you make disciples. Can I just get a couple of witnesses to say it'll work? It works. Can I just get some hearts and some love on there that whoever's out here listening thinking I'm the only one talking about that. Can I get some witnesses to testify? See, that's what our testimony need to be about. Won't he do it? Won't even now he'll still do it? Somebody else just took our run and said, it works. Somebody's at the laundromat right now. They think you crazy. Running around the laundromat saying, it works. It works when you work it. Wake up in your mind. Get up in your thinking and move in your purpose. Look, we get some testimonies out there. It works. It works. I'm telling you, it works. And even when you slip up, it even works more when you fulfill the lust of your flesh. What is lust? Control. That's all it is. I know you don't want me to know you listening to this message, but this has really got you because now you understand why you always want to be in control. It's because of lust. And enough is enough. Heavenly Father God, right now, we bind the spirit of lust right now. We loose the spirit of love, joy, peace, understanding, every fruit of the spirit that will separate us from the lust of our flesh. We bind it on earth that it may be loosed in heaven. And now we loose the spirit that it will be loosed on earth. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You'll never be the same. You will never, ever be the same. You will never, ever be the same. Somebody just in your spirit said, so I got a friend needed to play. Then play, tag them and send them the replay. Or send them to my YouTube station, Pastor E2000. Or wait for the replay to come up in less than 5 minutes and when I'm done. And say, this message, I heard it. It was for me, but we were just talking. We were saying we was in the same boat. Here go a word, not a man. Here go a word that will, first of all, watch this. Illuminate the mess, but free you. My God. Hey, shout out that I'm going to go shave from the spirit of flesh that you can walk in the spirit of freedom and have a life full of joy. Oh, my God. Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Wake up in your mind. Get up in your thinking. And move in your purpose. You guys join us tomorrow night for Women Speak Now with Pastor Valoris Brooks. Always, always, always on fire and with a word of accountability. I want you guys to join us tomorrow. That's 6 p.m. Pacific, 7 p.m. Mountain, 8 p.m. Central, 9 p.m. on the East Coast for Women Speak Now with Pastor Valoris Brooks. You guys don't want to miss it. All you got to do is call 319-527-6173. We love you guys. God bless you for continuing to follow and to continue to connect with us. I know you may miss a day or two. Go back and listen to the archives. I don't erase any broadcast. There'll be some. I'll be like, oh, I didn't do good enough. God won't let me erase nothing. He said, I did what I wanted to do through you. You thought you that was your feelings. I used you where I needed to use you. And I have to be just become a willing and a usable vessel. Amen. In Jesus' name. Family, I love you guys. I thank God for you. I appreciate you. I do. And everything God is doing and you seeing the benefits of the spirit of walking in the spirit. And it's a daily walk. Don't think you just walk once. Yes, you get filled, you get baptized and filled once. Then you should operate in the spirit every day because you won't fulfill the lust of your flesh. Wake up in your mind. Get up in your thinking and move in your purpose. Talk to you guys on Friday. We coming back. Oh, yeah, we're going to continue this journey. This is vessel preparation season, and we're going to do this thing in Jesus' name. Amen. Facebook, don't hang up. You know, we're going to say hi to everybody by name, everybody on Periscope. God bless you guys for being here today. Have a wonderful day. Know that you are loved, honored, and appreciated. But the most important thing, you better leave here knowing you are God's greatest miracle. Act like it. Amen. Amen. Hey, I love you guys too. I love you guys too. We are family. That's the period. Nothing you can do about it. I don't care. They don't like me. So what? We don't. They don't. That's look. Check this out. We have to stop being the ones on the pulpits, on the platforms, talking about love. And I don't hate nobody. If we had a little bump in our relationship or our connection or whatever, I don't hate you for that. It's just some people you're not lined up to work with. That doesn't make them bad. That just makes you guys didn't do enough investigation. I want to talk to a married couple this morning, just in the spirit. I'm picking this up. You guys are looking around like, why are we married? You didn't investigate each other good enough. You didn't ask the right questions. I guarantee you had sex too early. Sex was good, and that's all that your relationship. Oh, thank you, Holy Ghost. I'm talking to somebody that's not married too. There's a relationship out there that you guys have built on sex, and now that you ain't having sex like you used to, that ain't working. Look, you gotta sometime reevaluate yourself. I'm just gonna tell you the truth. I don't believe in divorce. I don't believe in no. But sometimes you made a wrong mistake, and all you're gonna do is make things worse unless you reevaluate yourself and recommit you guys self to either say, this we are wrong, forgive us, Lord, or we're going to do everything to get this thing right. We're going to separate from sex for a year so we can really learn each other. And then we're going to go on another honeymoon. Oh, and I'll guarantee you the sex, the love making that you experience from that point will be what you should experience the first time. But there's some out there are just not going to make it. You are going to kill each other. And you need to make a conscious decision and say, I'm going to do everything to make it work. And if you're not willing to do that, do everything to make it work. Whatever sin you were in that you got in, you got to break that sin. It's not going to just get better. If you got in a relationship and you know you was wrong, you must make it right. I'm not telling you to throw the relationship away. I'm telling you to get the relationship right. But that's not just one being right. That's not what. That's both being right and acknowledging we messed up. We did not find. We just ran across. When you find a good thing, no, man, I'm talking to my brothers out there. When you find a good thing, you will treat it like a good thing. You will nurture it like a good thing. And it will grow like a good thing because a good thing will treat you like you're a good thing. It's mutual. It's one accord. And you can fix it. But if you're not willing to surrender to God, not each other, if you're not willing to surrender to God, not a counselor, if you're not willing to surrender to God, not a church, if you're not willing to surrender to God completely in confession, then you got to make the right decision to make it right. Nobody has to get hurt. Nobody has to lose. Nobody has to be without. If you and I learn to walk in the spirit, we will do everything right. That was a fivefold extra message that God put in my heart that I had to get out today. And I'm obedient. I walk in the spirit because I know how to hear the spirit and speak the spirit. You say, well, look what Pastor E did. I'm going to say it to you again on loudspeaker in front of millions and millions of people. Pastor E ain't nothing. I'm just a vessel of my fivefold gifts. And when they light up and I operate under the power of the Holy Ghost Spirit. And I don't take no credit. None. Because then it won't work. Then it won't come to pass. I've spoken some prophetic things into your lives. And the only reason they came as prophetic, that they were spoken, is because I had no control or had no, I get no credit for it. Or, guess what? Or, it wouldn't have worked. Stop blaming me. No. Give God the glory. Stop discrediting me. Give it to God. Stop saying I'm this, I'm that, I'm not this, I am that. No. Give it to God. Anything I am for God. And the minister, hey, look. I guarantee you. And I'm just telling you, the Spirit is talking to her and I'm hearing it right now. She gonna preach on her next Women Speak Now. Be pure, flee fornication. Minister Charlene, she just said it about 10 times. She shouted it. Be pure, flee fornication. Stop having sex. I guarantee you, if you guys make a decision to break away from sex for 1 year, you still stay in the same home, but you flee from fornication and you build a personal relationship with God together, woo, the benefits on the other side are incomparable. Your marriage will work. But that's the only way to work. Thank you, Holy Ghost. He said that wasn't just for one. That's a bunch of couples need to hear that one. And he going to make sure they hear it. They go, how did I get on this broadcast? At the very end of it, this is what he wanted to be heard today through some couples that are married and unmarried. That you need to do one thing, and that's get it right. Wake up in your mind. Get up in your thinking and move in your purpose and run from sexual sin. Be holy. Good morning, Minister Terry. Good morning, Minister Charlene. Good morning, Evangelist Virginia. Good morning, Pastor Brian. Good morning, Minister Dorothy Ramey. Haven't seen you around for a while. Welcome back. Minister Ozan Ashley. I think first time or maybe second time seeing you around. Welcome back. Keep on coming. Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays. Minister Curtis Odom, Now Church California in the house. Yes, it does work. Minister Shannon Jones, good morning, woman of God. Good morning, Minister Cynthia Bell, good morning. Pastor Dwayne Collins, good morning, Madison, Wisconsin. Woo, glory, I still feel that spirit moving. Drunk in it. Ooh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I know somebody just said their spirit is like, man, my finances are shifting. And I think it was because I started sowing here. It is. God told me to tell you that. Minister Gail Fallon, good morning, woman of God. Hey, look, I wasn't mind reading. I heard what you were saying in the spirit. And God told me to tell me. That's why. Ooh, Minister Tish Renaud, first time seeing you on board. Welcome, woman of God. Come back again every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, 9 p.m. Pacific, 10 Mountain, 11 Central, 12 noon on the East Coast. Or come back later. Minister Barry Scott, what's up? Oh, Holy Ghost. Minister Ernest King, good morning. Minister Yolanda K. Whitecraft, good morning. Haven't seen you for a while. Minister Tia Wallace, good morning. Think my first time seeing you on board. Welcome. Keep coming back each Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Yep, we on time. Or maybe a minute here or there. Minister Lourdes Rusty Gomez, good morning. God bless you. First time seeing you. Welcome. Keep coming back. Minister Christina Lockett, come on back. Keep coming back. Yes, welcome. Amen. And all those that will come later and listening to the archives. And Minister Rosalind Douglas, good morning. God bless you. You coming on board. But you listen to the watch party. There was some great word for each and every one of us. enjoy. And if you know somebody that this word was for as well as you, tag them, share it. This was a prophetic word today. I think all of us need to hear. I can't wait until we get off so I can listen to my message being delivered directly to me. Amen. I love you guys. I thank God for you. Know that you are loved, honored, and appreciated. But know that you are God's greatest miracle. And don't let nobody shift that. Stay consistent in knowing God loves you. And he has not given up on you. Amen. Good morning, Rosalind Douglas. That is Minister Terry's cousin. Good morning. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Minister Charlene. On time word. When? Now. Talk to you guys later. Love you.